Morning, it's the start of day two, and they've already drained the system totally, and it's a bit of chaos here in the house right now. There's a few radiators off the wall, they've started changing those. The electrician has started taking all the wiring out for the old heating system, and there's a couple of gas engineers here. They're capping the gas pipe to the boiler, and they're also going to cap the gas pipe to my gas fire as well, because that's broken anyway. Right now guys are in the back garden and they are building the base. Well, they're cutting slabs, don't know if you can hear that, cutting slabs and wood and stuff to make a base for the heat pump to sit on. So once it quietens down a bit, I'll take you around and show you what's going on. Yeah, that boiler's definitely not going to work anymore, not just for the electrical reasons, but also because the gas has been capped down here. Here's the gas pipe, and it runs all the way down here. If I keep going down here to the bottom, oh, there's just a great big cap on the end of where it comes in. So no more gas to the garage. They also very kindly put a cap on the gas feed to this fireplace here, because there was a little AA battery inside it and it had gone all corroded, so now even the ignition spark won't work on it. So this fireplace is basically done for, so they've capped the gas off, and now this should be safe to me for me to remove whenever I get chance. So they've built the base for the heat pump to go on, and it's got a couple of concrete blocks there for the feet to sit on, and they're going to fill it full of gravel, I assume, so it'll act as a soakaway. The diking controller's on the wall now, but it looks like somebody was a little bit lazy with the decorating behind the old thermostat, so I think I'm going to have to tidy that up at some point. Right, so obviously we've got no heating tonight, so what I've done is I've gone round and put a few electric heaters in strategic rooms in the house. This one is going to actually heat the bedroom because it heats up quickly, and we're borrowing an oil radiator off a family member just for the next couple of days, so hopefully that should tide us through until the heating system's back up and running. So it's quite dark now because it's the end of the second day, and the heat pump has been installed in its final position. I'll show you that in a second. I feel a little bit guilty because I asked them to make the soakaway base a little bit smaller, and they have done that, and they've done a stunning job. So let's have a look. So there it is in position. You can see the base is looking nice and compact. It's the exact width of the legs, more or less, now. So if I show down here, you can see it fits on nicely, and there's a good gap down the back for airflow too. Start of day three then. Last night wasn't bad. The electric heaters worked really well, so we've got an oil radiator here in the living room, and we put got an electric convection heater in my room, and a mixture of fan heaters and infrared heaters in the kids' rooms. We even had a warm shower this morning because the hot water tank hasn't been taken out yet, and good old Eddie, the hot water diverter, is still powered up and controlling the immersion heater, which was good. I don't think we're going to get hot showers tomorrow. We'll have to see, because they did say they're going to take the hot water tank out today. But I guess they're waiting on some electric cable in order to be able to wire things up properly. But I guess they're going to get started on a lot of the plumbing today. So let's see how things pan out. So now I've had the gas capped to this fireplace, I've got a great big vent that goes all the way from the top of it to the roof of my house. It's the gas flue for the fireplace, and it's not needed anymore. And I can see inside there that it's clearly got quite a draft running through it, because there's cobwebs all sort of shimmering in the draft. So I'm going to try and find some way to bung that up now, and hopefully reduce the heat loss in here. Now, I know this isn't the proper way to do it, and I will get this done properly at some point. Certainly if this was an actual live working fire, you would never do this, but I've got an old towel here, and I'm going to try and stuff that inside the flue just to block up the vent, and let's see what happens. I hope this goes in. Well, I think that's worked. It's jammed in place, it's not going anywhere, so let's see if that makes a difference to the temperature of this room. It's cold and I'm hungry, so I'm going to go and get some Christmas dinner baguettes from a local sandwich shop, Harry's Baguettes, and they're really nice. They do Christmas baguettes all year round, but obviously as it's December I'm now allowed to go and buy one, so just walking around to get my car that I've parked around the corner so it's out the way of all the vans. There we go, big bag of food for everyone. This should go down okay. Yeah, so after all of that, I thought I'd better show you what you get. You get a massive baguette full of warm turkey with stuffing, and there's pigs in blankets there, and loads of cranberry sauce on it, and an extra pot of gravy on the side. So I've come up into my loft space because it's quite late in the evening now. Well, I say late in the evening, it's 5:45, and they're still going down in the garage, setting up the plant room, as they're calling it. They're putting some pipes through from my utility room to get hot and cold feeds into the heat pump. But I've come up to the loft because I wanted to see what had happened with the tanks that were up here, because they spent a good couple of hours cutting up tanks and removing pipes and things. There's a great big pile of junk on my drive at the moment. So my loft isn't the tidiest of rooms, I'll be honest with you. It's full of junk, but this platform right here used to have two tanks on it. There was a massive tank for the cold feed to the hot water tank, and then there was a smaller tank which was like the header tank for the central heating. Neither of those are needed now, and you can actually see the unused overflow pipes are sitting there, and obviously I've got this big platform, a little bit of water on the floor, which I'm sure is not a problem. It doesn't look like anything's too damp. I am going to have to sort out insulation though, because this insulation here is only around the edges, and I kind of need it underneath and on the plasterboard, so I'm going to sort that out now to try and keep things a bit warmer. Right, I'm round the other side now, and you can see I've pushed most of the insulation that was around the edge of this platform down onto the plasterboard, so it should be insulating it a lot better. I think I need to get one of those thermal cameras so as I can see where the cold spots are. And here's the inside of the airing cupboard. This is where the hot water tank used to be, and as you can see it is very empty and needs filling with shelves and things so as we can use it again. There was a lot of pipes up there all going up to the tanks in the loft, so now there's just some holes that I'm going to need to fill in. And there were a load of electrical boxes on the wall here, but they're not needed anymore apart from for this socket here, which does the shower that's up there. And that shower has been replaced. Well, that's the shower controller. That was a pumped one, and now it's not a pumped one, but we've not tested it yet. So this is our utility room, and we've got a sink there. Apologies, this isn't the tidiest it's ever been, because we haven't really cleaned it for a few days due to all the work going on. But the taps there are basically where we're going to be getting the hot and cold feeds from. And those have been taken from the cupboard, and they're coming round the side and the back of the tumble dryer. I don't know if you can see that. Let me get in a bit closer. Oh, it's not going to focus on that. But basically, yeah, those pipes there go through to the garage, and they're coming out of this wall here. And I assume they're going to go all the way up this wall and across the ceiling and to the plant area that's right behind me. And this then is the new plant area. Let me just pan down to show all of it. It's basically a load of pipes and valves. And I don't want to go outside too much because it's raining again now, but you can see that there's some electric wires down here. So the wiring has been done to the heat pump, so it can be turned on when it's ready, but there's no pipes to it yet. Those are going to be put in tomorrow. That's tomorrow's first job, I'm told. So yeah, that's the end of day three, or Wednesday as it's also known, I guess. They reckon they'll be finished and get the whole thing up and running by the end of tomorrow, and then maybe a few little things to tidy up first thing Friday morning. The house is currently left without heating, obviously, because the heat pump's not on, so we're going to be using the electric heaters again tonight. And there's no hot water tonight because they haven't managed to get the immersion heater into this tank, and obviously the water isn't fully connected yet, so no hot water, no heating, but hopefully this is the last night, because tomorrow will be air source heat pump heating and water. Thank you.